This is the ninth video in this series working with the pool table model in Blender. In the last video we started off making a start on our UV image. Left off with the idea that perhaps doing a quick test render would be a good idea. So I'll set up my camera really quickly. I'm not going to do anything special for setting up my camera and lighting. Just do a quick render to get a small idea of what it looks like. And the render could use the ambient occlusion setting being turned on, but we'll deal with that later on. Really, it's just a rough idea of what the table looks like now. What I'm seeing in my image is that around the semicircle, it has a little bit of jagged edge, and That's not all that happy. I'll probably be looking for a way to cure that if I can, but I'm not so sure that I can at the resolution of the UV image. Making a circle that isn't having some jaggies is not very, very likely at all, without blurring it considerably. The other thing I'm seeing is that the noise that I added to the image in the GIMP is sitting very nicely on the material, and it looks pretty good. It gives it a very nice quality. So that's it for that. I think the next thing to do would be to have a look at unwrapping the rails. Well, we can just get right on to that. So I'm going to zoom into those, take them into edit mode, select all, press the U key, and use the project from view option. And that'll place them into the UV mapping area. And what I'm going to want to do with these is, number one, I'm going to need to adjust the scale. I could do that by rotating it around, or I could do it a little more rough-like. So I'm going to do it a little more rough-like. Well, I'll try to explain the reason why this scale is important as I'm moving these parts around. And what I'm going to do is move all the parts down to the white area here at the end of the table, because I figure that's enough space to fit the map for the UVs. So I'm going to rotate the two ends around and then just start moving them into that location. And I'm going to try to line them up along the bottom. The reason I want to get the scale matching between the rails and the rest of the felt has to do with the HSV noise that was added. The HSV noise is like varied colored pixels, and when they're mapped onto the image of the felt at one scale, if I was to map them onto the image of the railings at another scale, what would happen is those pixels would grow or shrink on the rendered image. They would change in size as a result of the scale difference. It would express itself in that way. And that would be an undesirable side effect. It would kind of make the two materials look considerably different, where we want the materials to look mostly the same. So, in order to get them to the proper scale, what I would do is select them all and line them up more or less in the middle of that white area and simply scale them until they match up with the size of that end. And it may take a little bit of manipulating around to do that. But once I have them at the same scale as that end, things should work out pretty good. And what I'll need to do is compress them together now. I'm going to cut out of my video to do that. So now that I've got all those images placed in that area and scaled up into a reasonable size, I can now minimize Blender and open up my UV bitmap image. Move that layers dialog out of the way. And perhaps shrink this window a bit. Well, that didn't work out. Go over to my rectangular select tool, and I'm just going to copy and paste a section of my felt from this area to the end of the table. So I'll paste that, and I'll just grab it over. And it'd probably be a good idea to leave a white line in that area. And probably also be a good idea to zoom in to make sure on how much space I'm leaving there. And then I've got it lined up well. Then I'll come up into colors and adjust the levels a bit. And I'm just going to darken that area some. So I'll pull the black point over and play around with the white point or the gray point until it looks a suitable color. And I just want to change its overall color by a little bit. And I can OK that change. And save that image. And I'll just overwrite my old image. That's not going to prove too important. And we'll go into Blender. In Blender, we come into Image. And just simply reload. And that will reload the image with that in. Let's take a zoom in to have a look at everything sitting on that. And perhaps there's one of these isn't sitting that great onto that image. No, it looks okay. I think we can deal with that. So for the rail material, we'll need to initiate the text face option. And then we might as well go in, have a look through the camera and do a quick render. Now, without turning on ambient occlusion and having a closer look at this, the material of the felt isn't going to show up all that much. But rest assured that it will look very much like the material of the felt, and it will just be carrying a slightly different color. And later on, when we do a more close-up render, hopefully I'll be able to get that show on a YouTube video. So I'm going to glance at my time here, and I've only got a minute left. In the next video, we're going to address the wood grain and place a wood grain into our UV image here, and then map that for the wood and the legs, and see where we're at then. And until then, happy modeling.